We meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace, mercy, and peace be with you all. We have come here today to remember before God our sister Kim, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit her body to be buried, and to comfort one another in our grief. So welcome today to St. Peter and St. Paul's Church, as we do gather to give thanks for Kim and for her life. As we gather to mourn our loss, we think about all of those memories of good times spent with her. We come to say a very fond farewell and to be with one another at this difficult time. Welcome also to anybody that is joining us for the service from home. You're very welcome here with us today. As we begin our service, let us pray. God of all consolation, your Son Jesus Christ was moved to tears at the grave of Lazarus, his friend. Look with compassion on your children in their loss. Give to troubled hearts the light of hope, and strengthen in us the gift of faith in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our hymn this afternoon is from the 23rd Psalm, The Lord's My Shepherd. If you're able, do please stand as we sing together, but if you could keep your face coverings on, that would be really helpful. Thank you. Would you please be seated? I would like to invite Sarah to come and read to us some words from a poem.
The poem that I'm going to read, I think, has an essential truth for everyone, whether you're a person of faith or not, because the truth is nothing in this world ever actually dies. It transforms. And both Kim and I had a strong belief that the people that we loved, our family, friends that we've lost, that we were still connected to them, and for me, still am very much connected to them. And they gave me guidance, and they gave her guidance and support throughout her life. And this poem, I think, reflects aspects of how we both felt. Sorry, I don't have my glasses on. I give you this one thought to keep. I am with you still. I do not sleep. I am a thousand winds that blow. I am the diamond glints on the snow. I am the sunlight on ripened grain. I am the gentle autumn rain. When you awaken in the morning's hush, I am the swift, uplifting rush of quiet birds in circled flight. I am the soft stars that shine at night. Do not think of me as gone. I am with you still in each new dawn. God bless, Kim.
Thank you, Sarah. And picking up that theme, our reading from the Bible is taken from the Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." And so it is with sadness, but also with gratitude, that we look back on some stories from Kim's life. And as we do, I'd like to read some words that have been prepared by Kim herself and tweaked a little bit by her family. After graduating from Manchester University, Kim moved to London, where she lived all her working life. Kim was a dedicated teacher of children with special educational needs in London for over 35 years. She decided, after recovering from her first cancer diagnosis in 2017, to return to work after recovering from cancer treatment, operation, chemotherapy, and brachytherapy. She finally decided to hang up her proverbial chalk after August 2020, when she took retirement age 60 years old. Kim loved travelling, and spent many years travelling to countries far and wide. France, Spain, Germany, Transylvania, and Russia. And whilst in Russia, Kim and her friend Pam were caught up in the middle of a revolution. Exciting but scary. But it was all just a coincidence that whilst visiting the Kremlin, it led to the collapse of the Soviet Union. In Transylvania, with four colleagues from work, she visited Dracula's castle, having lots of adventures over there. She visited her Thai friend Supatra in Thailand and had a fantastic month's holiday. She also went travelling in Australia with a 3-day stopover in Singapore. A trip to the Ritz in London for her next birthday was high on her agenda too. The best holiday of all, though, was her trip to Graceland in Memphis, home of her favourite entertainer, Elvis Presley, in the 1980s. It was Kim's dearest wish to travel there again and meet up with her Elvis sister friend, Nora, and have more fun times. Sadly, it wasn't to be. Kim was such a huge fan of Elvis Presley. She set up her own online Elvis fan group over 2 years ago, where her co-admins helped to manage the group with her, Nora Kelly in America and Ava Russell in Australia. After many attempts at passing her driving test and increasing her father's blood pressure, Kim eventually passed her test. Owning several cars over the years, Kim finally changed her faithful 16-year-old Nissan for a brand new Kia Picanto, in red, of course. And like all her previous cars, this one had a name too, Elvis Brandon. In anticipation of moving back to Derbyshire, Kim joined a local book group, the Book Tarts. Kim was a voracious reader and always had a pile of books waiting to be read. Kim's favourite flower was the sweet pea, so please take a packet of flower seeds and plant them in her memory. And finally, in the words of Kim, when she finished a phone call with you, toodlepips, overandout.com. I'd also like to add some thoughts from Sarah. She says that whilst not wanting to dwell on the negative aspects of her health, she had such a lot to deal with and, to be honest, I was in awe of how well she coped with it. She always joked that she was a martyr to her body. Her rare mast cell condition, for example, which for a year or so regularly had her in and out of hospital with anaphylactic shock until her medication was sorted. It was incredibly frightening for her, living on her own as she did, worrying that she might die before the paramedics arrived. But she was fiercely independent and bore so much of her ill health with humour and without complaint. I remember that in 2015, when she broke both her elbows and had to stay in a care home, she could not do anything for herself. And though initially frustrating and embarrassing, she laughed about how gradually she'd become institutionalized and was reluctant to clean even her own teeth when staff said she was ready to do so. She would tell me about her experiences in all the different hospitals and care settings with the doctors, nursing staff, patients and visitors, making preparations for the book she planned to write in retirement based on her keen observations. She regularly rated hospitals on the quality of food and care she received. When well enough to enjoy them, she was especially fond of the BLTs and lattes from Charing Cross Hospital Cafe. She had a tough time, one way or another. And like a great many teachers, she dedicated so much of her life to providing the best support for the children she taught. Working alongside her for years, I knew she was possibly the best teacher in the school. She was intelligent and talented, and she made a real difference to the lives of her pupils. It is such a shame that her health just did not enable her to enjoy the retirement she so richly deserved. Thank you for your tributes to Kim for today. As I went to visit Kim's family, I had quite a surprise. Whilst chatting, I sensed something in my peripheral vision, which made me jump. On the stairs of her home was a cardboard cutout of Elvis. It looked so lifelike and just shows how much she thought of him. She was also drawn to anything pink. I'm told that when out and about, if she saw something pink, she just had to buy it. She loved the colour, and it's a fitting tribute that so many of us today are wearing something pink in her memory. She also had a love of handbags. Her family found about 30 of them in her house after they started sorting things out. But sadly, for each of us gathered here today, and for those who unfortunately can't be here, Kim has now died and is at peace. Her passing will leave a huge hole in each of your lives, which will take time to heal. I know that each of you will have your own stories of time that you spent with Kim and all that she means to you. We're saddened that she's no longer with us, but thankful for the time spent with her. As we mourn Kim's passing, there are some words of comfort and hope which speak to us from the Bible today. The reading reminds us that Jesus goes to make a place ready for each of us. When the time is right, he calls us home to our Father's house in heaven. Kim has now taken this journey and is resting in peace and for all eternity. The reading offers us the same promise too. Whilst we're saddened by losing Kim, we can look forward to making the same journey that she already has. When the time is right, God will call each of us home too, and we'll be reunited with Kim and all who have gone before us in our Father's house in heaven. And as I say, I know that each of you will have your own stories and precious memories of Kim and the time that you will each have spent with her. So I'd like to invite us to pause for a moment, to grab hold of those memories and to treasure them. Take hold of them and store those stories to take with you wherever you go. And as we pause and reflect, we'll listen to Where No One Stands Alone.
Once I stood in the night with my head bowed low, in the darkness as black as could be, and my heart felt alone, and I cried, oh, to call my own.
So holding those moments and memories tightly to us, let us pray. If you wish to join in with the prayers today, when I say, Lord, in your mercy, please respond, hear our prayer. God of mercy and Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Kim, for the grace and mercy she received from you, for all that was good in her life, for the memories we treasure today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You promise eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good this, your servant Kim, as we also remember her. Bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look with mercy on Kim's family and friends and all who mourn. Give them patient faith in times of darkness. Strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, our Father, we thank you that you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to die for us and to rise again. His cross declares your love to be without limit. His resurrection, that death, our last enemy, is doomed. By his victory, we are assured of the promise that you will never leave us or forsake us, that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. So, drawing our prayers together, we pray in the words that our Saviour Jesus taught us. The Lord's Prayer in its traditional form. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So, just before we commit Kim to God's eternal safekeeping, I've been asked to let you know that you're all welcome to join her family at Eckington Cemetery for the interment. There will then be refreshments at Mosborough Hall Hotel, to which you are also warmly invited. So let us commend our sister Kim to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. If you're able, would you please stand? God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust him to your mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you, now and forever. Amen.
Goodbye, darling, down the road I go.